Good afternoon, everybody. This is Sangeeta Saxena, editor, Aviation and Defense Universe, getting you live from Eurosatory 2024. We are here at Parc des Expositions, Paris, and we are at the India Pavilion at the Gliders India Limited. We have with us Mr. Sunil Date, who is the Director Operations and HR for Gliders India. Welcome, Mr. Date, to ADU's chat room.
Thank you, madam. I am glad to be here today.
And sir, this is one of the offshoots of the erstwhile OFB. Please tell us, what are you doing here and about the new branding?
Thank you, madam. Gliders India Limited is the successor entity of erstwhile Arnas Factory Board in the field of parachutes and rubber flotation products.
And sir, what have you got here? Today is day 3 at Eurosatory. What are you showcasing here, sir?
Basically, we are showcasing our products in parachute domain, which we are looking at entering into European market. We have here our PTM, that is Paratactical Assault Trained Parachute, which is the time-tested and trusted parachute used by Indian Armed Forces. We are manufacturing this parachute for more than 20 years, and we believe that more than 1 million jumps have been carried out using this parachute, and we take pride in stating that so far we have not received any casualty report for this parachute. So that speaks itself of the quality that we try to build into our products. We also do heavy drop parachutes of 3-ton and 7-ton category. We believe there will be a market for this because supply dropping is picking up. Supply dropping right from 150 kg to 3 tons to 1 ton and 7 ton denominations with. We also do a lot of brake and pilot parachutes for air forces. We have Western as well as Eastern fleets, that Jaguar, Mirage and Hawk parachutes on the Western side, and Sukhoi 30, MiG-21 and MiG-23 and MiG-29 parachutes in Russian block. So we do all these aircrafts, brakes and pilot parachutes. We are having good market in Asia, and now we are looking for markets in Europe.
In Asia, apart from India, so which countries?
Southeast Asian countries we have been supplying. Earlier we have supplied to Indonesia, Malaysia, and we have supplied to Vietnam recently, a very big order. So we are looking at European countries of Eastern Europe side as well as Western Europe.
So today is day 3 at Eurosatory, and how has the footfall been for you?
There has been a very good footfall at our stall and India Pavilion in general. We have been consistently getting leads. We have been getting leads for mostly for supply drop parachutes and brake and pilot parachutes.
Okay.
So we anticipate a good business from this exhibition.
And sir, here in the Eurosatory, apart from European countries, you also have the other continents. So have you got some queries from them?
Yes, we have been getting queries from Middle East and African continent.
Right. And sir, is this because you already have an existing export market? So sir, is this the first time you're at a show outside India, or do you do DSEI and other shows also so that you get a larger market?
After becoming a defense public sector undertaking, we have been participating in shows in Southeast Asia, but Europe we have come first.
Europe you've come for the first time. And sir, all this we see here, all the parachutes we see here, are they totally Indian, or is there some in the supply chain, some content which comes from abroad?
As on date, GIL, all parachutes are 100% made in India. So this is a concept of our Honorable Prime Minister, made in India and made for the world.
Yeah.
So we are following that. No indigenous, import content in our parachute. Everything right from fabric, tapes, cordages, everything is made in India.
Everything is made in India. So your supply chain is totally Indian?
Supply chain is 100%.
100% Indian. And sir, like we know that parachutes are used in the SF forces, and you know, you have the para commando regiments. So sir, and of course for the Air Force. So in addition to that, sir, all the paramilitary which have their aircraft are also your clients, sir?
Paramilitary, we don't have any clients for aircraft or brake and pirate parachutes, but we do have clients for some other civil products like NBC suits that we have been giving. It gives protection against nuclear radiations.
Okay.
So that suit we are selling in the civil market.
In the civil market. And so what about the police forces and all?
Police forces we are not dealing right now.
Alright, okay. Because BSF like has a full squadron of aircraft, and the police forces also have a lot of requirements.
Special Frontier Forces we do, but
you do.
Police forces we don't do. Special Frontier Forces is a separate wing of army only.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we do
that is separate. You do parachutes, right? And sir, at the end of the day, have you ever tried? Everybody who wants to try an export market wants to export to US. So have you, thought on those lines?
Yes, we have thought on those lines, and in fact, we had one lead going for quite some time, and it is coming almost to some fruition now. So let us hope in next couple of months we are able to get our first order from this. Let us hope for that.
Let's hope, sir. Let's keep our fingers crossed. I'm sure it'll come out. And sir, post OFB, Gliders India is still in its infancy. How have you felt the development? How is it different from having been a, purely government enterprise, and then suddenly you become a PSU? So how different is it?
It has been a very great journey for last nearly 3 years now, more than 2.5 years. And yes, we have got the flexibility that we always wanted. Now we are more autonomous. We are able to take faster decisions. Earlier times, coming to an exhibition like Eurosatory used to take lot of government clearances, papers are going up to ministry for deputation of our people, but now we can do it at our level, and there is full support from government of India. So we are able to expand, we are able to diversify, we are able to show our better face to the world.
Right, absolutely. And sir, is there anything you'd like to add from your side?
We wish more and more business, not only to us, but all the participants of India Pavilion, so that the vision of $5 billion US dollar export market is achieved.
Sir, I'm seeing your video and I'm seeing a lot of women stitching. So is that a very big employment generation for ladies,
yes,
sir?
Yes, yes. Our, specifically our factory at Kanpur has got lot of strength of women, and they find a very conducive environment. In fact, my colleague, Madam Pratiksha Saini, as you can see, she is the international head of marketing for Gliders India.
Okay, very nice. So it's nice to have a woman heading a division, and then the television, of course, shows so many of them stitching. It's a great thing for women who are sitting at home and actually not doing anything, are getting so much of work from your factory.
Exactly. Yes.
So what is the strength of women in there who would be working for you?
There are almost 25 to 30% workforce.
Right. Okay. Very nice. Thank you so much, both of you.
Thank
wonderful,
you.
Sir. And wonderful to have met you. Always nice to meet a woman at the helm of affairs.
Oh, thank you so much.
And we wish you all the best. We just hope that Gliders keeps gliding.
Yes,
so it'll be great.
Thank you. Thank you so much.